but only one can show us who we are. We are made in the image of, made in the image of God. Beautiful shades of love.
God Made Me and You, Celebrating God's Design for Ethnic Diversity, by Shay Lin, illustrated by Trish Mahoney. After this, I looked, and behold, a great multitude that no one could number, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." Revelation 7, 9-10. Our story begins on a typical day in the Bible class after recess and play. The children are there, but Miss Preston is late. They're talking and laughing out loud as they wait. Two of the boys were not too polite. They teased other kids with all their might. They teased one boy for the clothes he would wear, and one poor girl, they made fun of her hair. One boy cried when they laughed at his skin. It was just at this moment Miss Preston walked in. "I'm sorry I'm late. Hey, what's going on? And why are you crying, Todd? Tell me what's wrong." Todd didn't speak up, but Abigail Moore told Miss Preston what happened moments before. After she learned what the children had witnessed, she told the two boys to ask for forgiveness. Then she spoke to the class. "Now, kids, listen here. I've said it before, but I'll make myself clear. All God's creatures must be respected. Bullying of any kind won't be accepted. Here are the Grace Christian School rules. Respect others, be kind, listen, follow directions. It's a privilege for you to attend this school. You will be expelled if you can't keep this rule. Don't be afraid to ask me any questions, but let's start with how this relates to our lesson. We're in Acts, following Paul the Apostle as he travels through Greece proclaiming the gospel. Acts 17 in the 26th verse says, God made from one man each nation on earth. What that means is we all have the same origin. Wherever we're born, we come from the same kin. Though many people find this hard to believe, our first parents were Adam and Eve. To bring many from one is what God decided. In this way, the whole human race is united. When God created the heavens and earth, he did it to show off his glory and worth. In Genesis 1, what we see in each verse is God made a world that is really diverse. The sun and the moon, the planets and stars, Saturn and Jupiter, Venus and Mars, each one is different. Plus, why did God make this? He made it to show off his beauty and greatness. From icebergs to insects, tornadoes to trees, from lions to lizards, flamingos to fleas. Each in their own way, their God, they are praising. Their differences cry out, God is amazing. But the crown jewel of the work of his hand are those made in his image, both woman and man. And just as two snowflakes are never the same, each person is different, unique in their frame. God made us all, each kind and each sort. He made some people tall and some people short. He gave some curly hair while others have straight. It pleased God to fashion each wonderful trait. Brown eyes and green eyes, hazel and blue, each in their own way works of art we can view. Some that are deaf and some that are blind, all have great worth in God's sovereign design. Dark skin, light skin, and all in between, in each color and shade, God's beauty is seen. The Lord knows the number of hairs on your head, whether brown or black, whether blonde, gray, or red. What some call ethnicity and others call race, we should celebrate as a gift of God's grace. You are wondrously made in the womb by God's hand. You are no accident. You are part of his plan. Rachel and Billy, Keisha, Abigail, Todd, you're wonderfully made in the image of God. Carlos, Jennifer, Tyler, Sean, Corey, God made you. You exist for his glory. But back in the garden with Adam and Eve, the serpent appeared with intent to deceive. They ate from the tree that God had forbidden. From that point on, from their eyes, God was hidden. The sin in each human would soon be discovered. When Cain, the firstborn son, hated his brother. Because of their sin, the world was now cursed, and people's behavior would only get worse. And now, because of the presence of sin, people hate for silly things like color of skin. The very differences meant to give God praise are now reasons for hatred. So evil are our ways. But God already had a solution in mind. He sent Jesus to die for the sins of mankind. At the cross, we see what God's love is all about. There's no type of person that Jesus left out. Because Jesus died and rose from the grave, all those who trust in the Lord will be saved. And since that time, what the Spirit has done is drawn many to God through faith in his Son. All over the world, God is filling up churches with saints of all colors that Jesus has purchased. God turns strangers into sisters and brothers. Though different, we're called to love one another. Merci, arigato, shukran, guillabonga, gracias, mahalo, thank you, spasibo. In the book of Revelation, chapter 7, the church from all times is gathered in heaven. A great multitude that no one could number praise God with voices louder than thunder. Each tribe, each people, each language, each nation, all thanking God for the gift of salvation. There's no sin in heaven, no hating each other, just love from the heart for our sisters and brothers. We'll no longer view our distinctions as odd, but rather more reasons to give praise to God. Together forever with saints of all kinds, this is exactly what God has designed. Our lesson's almost over. It won't be long. Let's finish our time by singing this song. Though we all have a different story, God made me and you. God made me and you for our joy and for his glory. God made me and you. God made me and you. Different colors and different shades, all fearfully and wonderfully made. Through each, the glory of God displayed. God made me and you. Though all are valued, all are lost, all have great need for the cross. Jesus died, rose, and paid the cost. God made me and you. Though we all have a different story, God made me and you. God made me and you. For our joy and for his glory, God made me and you. God made me and you.
We are made in the image of, made in the image of God. Yeah.